नमस्ते, वेलकम टू कैवल्य योगा गुरुकुलम KYG, एज वी ऑल नो इट। लेट अस बिगिन द सेशन विद वन ओम एंड देन ऑफर आवर सैल्यूटेशंस टू आवर गुरु एंड इनवोक द गणेश फ्रॉम द मूलाधार। Let us offer our reverential salutations to the divine Sadguru. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. Let us invoke the Ganesha from the Mooladhara. Om Ganganapataye Namaha. Let's begin by reviewing the 22 verses of the Shivopasana mantra that we have learnt so far.
Nidhanapataye Namaha.
Each line twice.
Nidhanapataye Namaha.
We chant it together, so please join along.
Nidhanapatantikaya Namaha. Nidhanapatantikaya Namaha.
After year, let us not pause, let us continue naturally.
Urdhvaya Namaha.
Again.
Urdhvaya Namaha.
Next.
Urdhvalingaya Namaha. Urdhvalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Hiranyaya Namaha.
Again.
Hiranyaya Namaha.
Next.
Hiranyalingaya Namaha. Hiranyalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Suvarnaya Namaha.
Again.
Suvarnaya Namaha.
Next.
Suvarnalingaya Namaha. Suvarnalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Divyaya Namaha.
Again.
Divyaya Namaha.
Next.
Divyalingaya Namaha. Divyalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Bhavaya Namaha.
Again.
Bhavaya Namaha.
Next.
Bhavalingaya Namaha.
Again.
Bhavalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Sharvaya Namaha.
Again.
Sharvaya Namaha.
Next.
Sharvalingaya Namaha.
Again.
Sharvalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Shivaya Namaha.
Again.
Shivaya Namaha.
Next.
Shivalingaya Namaha.
Again.
Shivalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Jvalaya Namaha.
Again.
Jvalaya Namaha.
Next.
Jvalalingaya Namaha.
Again.
Jvalalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Atmaya Namaha.
Again.
Atmaya Namaha.
Next.
Atmalingaya Namaha.
Again.
Atmalingaya Namaha.
Next.
Paramaya Namaha.
Again.
Paramaya Namaha.
Next line.
Paramalingaya Namaha.
अगेन
परमलिंगाय नमः.
एक्सलेंट. सो दीज आर ऑल द 22 वर्सेस दैट वी स्टडीड. नाउ टुडे वी विल डू द 23rd एंड होपफुली द 24th एज वेल. दीज आर टू लॉन्गर वर्सेस. And then 25th to 35th, it becomes easier. And then the last three verses are a little more longer. So this verse goes like this. Please just listen and we'll take it part by part.
Etat somasya suryasya sarvalingagasthapayati pani mantram pavitram.
Let us examine this, understand this and learn how to chant it. Whenever you see longer Vedic verses being chanted, don't get intimidated by the length of the verse. Break it into smaller pieces, learn bits, and then you can, it's easily joined. So let's take the first two words.
Etat somasya suryasya.
Etat means now. Now that I have chanted all this, now, at this moment, that I'm holding this linga in my hand or in my consciousness or in the altar.
Etat, now.
Somasya suryasya, the moon and the sun. Soma means moon, surya means the sun. So this is a reference to the sun and the moon that we see around the planet Earth. But there's a greater inner reference to the Ida and the Pingala nadis in us. So when these two cross together, each of those places become an altar for the lingam to be established. When they cross, then these are two nadis. The Ida is the left, the Pingala represents the right side of the body. And they cross at six different places, the six centers of consciousness, the six chakras as we know it. They cross there each. So when they cross, that place becomes, it's like the, you know, like the four road crossing in the traffic. So imagine if there was nobody to control there, no traffic man to control there, no traffic lights to control there. It can create havoc, right? So that is why the focus is always on these six centers where these nadis cross each other. The Ida and the Pingala cross each other. So it becomes an important point. So any of these six centers of consciousness, you can meditate as you place this linga. So these are things you can develop on your own. Or if you find these things too complicated, just hold it in the center of your eye or hold it in your heart. The heart is, for this particular thing, it comes to the heart chakra, and I'll explain to that as we come to that particular line. So it's nice to hold the linga, the concept of the linga, the consciousness of the linga, the image of the linga, the symbolism of the linga in your heart as you install it. Because we are installing this linga in this particular beautiful verse. So we say, etat somasya suryasya, as the sun and the moon, bringing together the sun and the moon into the linga. That means we are focusing on a particular center of consciousness. And in this particular case, the heart. And I'll tell you why. So that is how the meaning of these two words are. How is it chanted? Please listen.
Etat somasya.
So it's straight and this time it goes up.
Etat somasya.
Let's chant it together twice.
Etat somasya.
Again.
Etat somasya.
Wonderful.
Suryasya.
Su is long here.
Suryasya.
Yasya is lower than sur. Let's chant it together.
Suryasya.
Again.
Suryasya.
Together, both these words.
Etat somasya suryasya.
Again.
Etat somasya suryasya.
There is a beauty in this chant, right? After somasya, immediately switch to suryasya. So, listen again how beautifully it flows.
Etat somasya suryasya.
Let's do it again, twice.
Etat somasya suryasya.
Again.
Etat somasya suryasya.
Beautiful. Then comes the next line.
Sarva linga ghasthapayati.
Sarva, the three words are there. Sarva, lingam, sthapayati. Sarvam means all. This all will have a reference in the next line. All of this, pavitram, it will come. Pavitram means purifying. So all gets purified. The one who is holding the lingam, the place where the lingam is being established, the lingam itself, everything becomes pure. So that sarva here is reference to the next word that follows in the word that follows these two words, right? So that don't apply the logic of English phrases and English language to Sanskrit and say, why doesn't the purify come after all us purified? It doesn't work like that. It's a different language. And more on top of that, it's a poetry language. So the words are muddled up so that there's a beauty of the poetry kept. Anyway, so sarva, all. Lingam. Lingam is the symbolic Shivalinga that we are meditating upon, that we are holding in our hand or in the altar or in the mind's eye. In this case, the heart chakra. Because the question will come, where do I meditate? What is the ideal way to meditate for Shivopasana? This is a pasana with a lot of bhakti in it. So the heart chakra. And why the heart chakra is explained in the next line. It's very subtly, the way I have understood it and the way I practice it. So I'll share that with you. It's up to you to take it or leave it. And these are all matter of perspectives. So, now sarva lingam sthapayati. Sthapayati means installation. Installation, install means sthapayati means come establish yourself. Once and for all, it's established. That's it. That is the beauty of that, right? So sthapayati. Now in some of the sandhi rules that goes in Veda, in Vedic chanting, one of them is this. Lingam. When M or N, M or N, in some other chants you will come across the N that ends here. In this case it's lingam. If that M or N is followed by sa, sha, and so on, then the M becomes gg, g, lingag. It becomes like that because it is followed by a sa in this particular case. So it could be sa, sha, sha, all of that. So that could, now on top of that, why it becomes gag is thas, the sa that follows is not a complete consonant. If you notice there, the sa is cut off by another tha. So stha it is becoming. So especially when it becomes a half consonant or a semi-consonant, then the g, lingam, becomes lingag. Okay? So there are rules like these. And there are exceptions to these rules. That's where it becomes complicated. But anyway, that gag is just a sandhi. It's a rule applied because lingam is joined by a semi-consonant. Semi-consonant. Remember that. That's why it becomes lingag. Okay? Sarvalingaghas. Sthapayati. Listen again. Sarvalingaghas. Sarvalingaghas. Just ghas. Just a little bit of that touch. Sarvalingaghas. Sthapayati. Not sthapayati. 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 There has to be an energy there that establishes there. Sarvalingaghas. Sthapayati. Okay? Alright, let's chant it together, twice, together, both the words. Sarvalingaghasthapayati. Again. Sarvalingaghasthapayati. Again. Sarvalingaghasthapayati. One more time. Sarvalingaghasthapayati. One more time. Sarvalingaghasthapayati. Excellent. Okay. So, what was the last one? Let's chant it together. Etat somasya suryasya. Again. Etat somasya suryasya. This one. Sarvalingaghasthapayati. Again. Sarvalingaghasthapayati. Wonderful. Now, the third line. Pani mantram pavitram. Pani mantram pavitram. Three words again here. Very simple. Pani here refers to anything that is holding it. The capacity to hold. A shop can be called pani because a shop contains a lot of items in it. Right? So in this case, Pani is referred to as the hand. Pani, which I am holding in my hand. So whenever there's a reference to Pani, the capacity to hold, it refers to your heart, because which is the organ in your body that can hold? Your feet cannot hold. It can touch things, but it can't hold. The fingers and the hand, the palm of your hand, is something that can actually hold something, right? That is why hands are used as a reference to holding. Now, hands and fingers that help you hold, fingers are connected to the Vayu element. And Vayu element is in the heart region. And therefore, when I read Pani Mantram, my mind automatically goes to the heart, right? All the five elements are in the five chakras. The fourth element is the Vayu element, which is in the region of the lungs, in the heart. And that is connected to the fingers. Vayu is connected to movement of fingers. So fingers and Vayu are connected. And therefore, the moment it says Pani, the ability to hold, grasp, then there is a reference, I feel and I believe, and that's how I imagine this. There is a reference to the heart chakra, and therefore the heart is where you establish this lingam. It also falls in place beautifully in our visualization, and therefore you're welcome if you like and tune into this kind of a concept to use it. So Pani, hands, or a place, wherever it's holding. Mantram. Mantram is all the 22 verses that we chanted, right? With the help of all those 22 verses, and in this meeting place of the sun and the moon, I am establishing this lingam, which renders everything pure. Sarvam, that sarvam which we read in the last line, comes here, pavitram. Because all of this is part of one verse, okay? They're not different verses, right? Pani mantram pavitram. Pavitram means purifies. So, how is it chanted? Listen to this. Pani mantram, Pani mantram, pavitram, pavitram. Let's take one word at a time. The first word. Let's chant it together. Pani mantram. Let's chant it twice. Together. Pani mantram. Again. Pani mantram. Wonderful. The next line. Pavitram. Let's chant it together twice. Pavitram, pavitram, pavitram. Both the words together. Pani mantram, pavitram. Two more times. Let's do it together. Pani mantram, pavitram. Again. Pani mantram, pavitram. Wonderful. Excellent. So now let's be bold and let's try this whole verse together. Twice, thrice, let's try that. Together. Etat somasya suryasya sarvalingagasthapayati pani mantram pavitram. Wonderful. Two more times. Etat somasya suryasya sarvalingagasthapayati pani mantram pavitram. Once more. Etat somasya suryasya sarvalingagasthapayati pani mantram pavitram. So far, what we have done is we visualize the lingam and begin to ascribe the qualities, and lingam became more and more empowered. And then finally, we established the lingam in the cave of our heart with this beautiful mantra. Installation happens. And now, after installation, we worship the Shiva consciousness. We worship the five faces of Shiva, if you will, the five aspects of Shiva. Beginning with this verse. In Nepal, there is a temple which has the five faces of Shiva. Four facing the four directions and the fifth one facing up. So let us explore what are these five faces of Shiva. We start with the first face, sadyo jatam. And that is this verse. So what is this verse?
Sadyo jatam prapadhyami sadyo jataya vai namo namaha.
The verse, this is half of the verse. So let us learn this first and then proceed. It's a beautiful thing. Now we are looking at the lingam, right? Imagine this in your meditation, how powerful this is. You've established it. Now each aspect of the lingam you're looking at. You're looking at the western side of the lingam. So let us explore this and study this verse. Listen to this.
Sadyo jatam prapadhyami.
Not me, it is short me.
Sadyo jatam prapadhyami.
Okay, what does it mean? Sadyo jatam
prapadhyami.
Prapadhyami is I take refuge. So that's a simpler word. Not to, maybe to pronounce, but to understand. Prapadhyami.
Sadhyo jata. To the sadhyo jata, I take refuge in the sadhyo jata. Sadhyo jata. Sadhya and jata is, sadhya means new, jata is born, newly born.
Newly born means, remember the sharva that we talked about, that bhava, that is ended. Now there is a new birth taking place in your consciousness of the Shiva. So sadhyo jata reminds you of this. He reminds you of this newly born, the first born, the newly born. Right?
Sadhyo jata.
So that is the beauty of this sentence. Okay? It is ascribed to the western face of Shiva. All this is for us to understand and tune into this divine concept. So listen to it one more time and we'll chant it twice.
Sadyo jatam prapadhyami. Sadyo jatam prapadhyami.
Okay, we'll take one word at a time.
Sadyo jatam.
This is simple. Let's chant it together twice.
Sadyo jatam. Sadyo jatam.
Once more.
Sadyo jatam.
Good.
Prapadhyami, prapadhyami.
The pra is up, dhyami is down.
Prapadhyami.
So there are three stages in the chant here. Let's chant it together.
Prapadhyami.
Two more times.
Prapadhyami.
Once more.
Prapadhyami.
Pra. Just throw that voice out there.
Prapadhyami.
Good. Let's chant it together. Listen to it once.
Sadyo jatam prapadhyami.
Let's chant it together.
Sadyo jatam prapadhyami.
Again.
Sadyo jatam prapadhyami.
Wonderful. Then, this is easy. Now that you understood, or rather beginning to understand the meaning of sadyo jata, the same thing is coming. I offer salutations. Again and again, namo namaha, namo namaha is again and again I offer salutations. Namaha, to whom? Sadyo jata, to this divine newly born, who's taking me to that state of consciousness where there is a new birth taking place. Sadyo jataya. So
sadyo jataya vai namo namaha. Sadyo jataya vai namo namaha.
The first word,
sadyo jataya, sadyo jataya.
Let's chant it together twice.
Sadyo jataya, sadyo jataya.
Wonderful.
Vai namo namaha.
Twice.
Vai namo namaha.
Again.
Vai namo namaha.
So here the namaha, the ma is going up. Okay, so here it is okay. Not in the previous ones. Alright, so let's chant it together, the whole line. Twice, or maybe three times.
Sadyo jataya vai namo namaha.
Again.
Sadyo jataya vai namo namaha.
Just one more time.
सद्योजाताय वै नमो नमः. ब्यूटिफुल. द नेक्स्ट वन इज भवा. That newly born we are talking about, right? That why is that newborn coming? Because the bhava, the present cycle, is ending. We have asked him to end it, right? Sharva ayanamaha. So that sharva linga ayanamaha. That bhava is suppressed, is being dissolved by Shiva consciousness. And therefore we are saying this, sadhyojata bhave bhave nati bhave. In other words, this bhava that is repeating itself again and again, take me ati bhave, take me beyond that, ati bhava, take me beyond that into a new cycle, into a new birth along with you. What is that new birth? Sadhyo jata is a new birth. That means the consciousness now reaches that of Shiva. Bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam. Bhave 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 bhave. Let's chant it together. Bhave 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 bhave. One more time. Bhave bhave. Next line. Nati bhave. Listen to it. Nati bhave. Together. Nati bhave. Again, nati bhave. This bha, like in bhavaya namaha, somebody had made a comment in the last class as well on YouTube. So it's a response, that is mahaprana. So bha can come, but don't make it a udata where it is not necessarily meant to be. Don't overstress it. Just create that energy bha. Bring in some pranic element into that. So how does that line go? Bhave bhave nati bhave. Bhave bhave nati bhave. Think of it as learning a simple tune that has only three notes. Okay, don't get too tight and too excited and too confused. La 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 la. That's how it goes. Bhave bhave nati bhave. Let's chant it one more time together. Bhave bhave nati bhave. The next line is bhavasvamam bhavasvamam bhavasvamam. Together. Bhavasvamam. Again. Bhavasvamam. Excellent. Let's chant this whole line. Listen to it once and then we'll chant it together two or three times. Bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam. Together. Bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam. Again. Bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam. One more time. Bhave bhave nati bhave bhavasvamam. If a particular line becomes difficult for you, and it can be difficult for you and not difficult for somebody else, then keep on repeating that line playfully in your mind, and then it'll settle. Sleep over it. Next day morning, it'll be there right in front of you, clear. The last line in this verse is, Bhavod Bhavaya Namaha. Bhavod Udbhavaya. From this Bhava, take me to the next Bhava, new birth. That is why that there was a reference to Sadhyojata and Bhava. Bhava and Sadhyojata are combined. Sadhyojata represents new birth. So we are telling Shiva and meditating on the concept of let this Bhava end, and from this Bhava, let that eternal cycle begin. That cycle which is not this present cycle. Not another cycle of birth and death, but the divine eternal moment, actually. That is the eternal moment that we are looking for, not the present cycle. And that comes out of this bhava. When this bhava dissolves, that arises. Bhava udbhava. Udbhava is that which rises, right? So, bhavod bhavaya namaha. Bhavod bhavaya. Udbhavaya, they are joined together. So once again, listen. Bhavod bhavaya namaha. Let's chant it together. भवोद्भवाय नमः।
अगेन
भवोद्भवाय नमः नमः।
व्हेनेवर यू सी रेड गो अप।
भवोद्भवाय नमः।
अगेन
भवोद्भवाय नमः।
ब्यूटिफुल। सो लेट्स जस्ट चैंट दिस टुगेदर इफ यू कैन, अदरवाइज लिसन। सद्यो ओके हियर इट इज।
सद्यो जातं प्रपद्यामि, सद्यो जातं प्रपद्यामि, सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः। सद्यो जाताय वै नमो नमः। भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्व माम्। भवे भवे नाति भवे भवस्व माम्। भवोद्भवाय नमः। भवोद्भवाय नमः।
सो टुडे वी हैव एस्टैब्लिश्ड द लिंग एंड मेडिटेटेड ऑन द वेस्टर्न फेस ऑफ शिवा, दैट साइड विच रिमाइंड्स अस ऑफ अ न्यू बर्थ इनटू द शिवा कॉन्शियसनेस। हाउ ब्यूटिफुल एंड पावरफुल इज दैट। सो कीप दैट इन योर माइंड, इन योर मेडिटेशंस एंड इन योर प्रेयर्स टुडे, एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू दिस लर्निंग एज वी गो अलॉन्ग। थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग। Let's end this class with one Om and three Shantis.
Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.